today, there are young people who are victims of child abuse, really ugly child abuse, that if I talked to you about specifics, you wouldn't be able to sleep tonight. Those people today are aging out of foster care. And tomorrow there'll be more. And the next day there'll be more. Where do they go? Well, if they have friends, they go to a friend's house and they stay there until basically the family is tired of having kids sleep on their couch and eat all their food. And they are either politely or not so politely asked to leave. It's called couch surfing. When you run out of friends who are willing to let you stay, or whose families are willing to let you stay, then you're on the street. And that's really scary. Just think about it. If you had to sleep outside tonight, where would you sleep? Where would you go? Where could you be that was safe? That you wouldn't be beat up, stolen from, sexually assaulted? You can't really sleep because you're just waiting for somebody, keeping your eyes open, vigilant, can't really sleep. And we know from Vanguard University's Global Center for Women and Justice, from interviews with rescued trafficking victims, that within 48 hours of being outside, sleeping outside, they're approached by a trafficker. And the trafficker comes around with food. And if you haven't eaten for a few days, a burger and fries and a soda is the most amazing thing you've ever seen in your life. And the trafficker says something like, "Oh, are you still here? Oh, nobody's come and see about you? Oh, I bet you're hungry. You know what? I happen to have my lunch. I'll give it to you. You can have my lunch. And you know what? I might have an outfit that would fit you. I bet you're dirty. I bet you want to shower so bad. Well, if you just come with me, you can have a shower. I probably have some clothes that'll fit you. You can actually get a good night's sleep. But you know, when you get in the car with that person, that's not what happens. And if I told you what really happened, you wouldn't just lose sleep for one night. You probably wouldn't sleep for a week. And you might not be the same ever again if you really knew. So the kids who are aging out of foster care today and tomorrow and the next day are the next homeless people. They're the next trafficked people. And you know, trafficking is a nice little euphemism for being raped for money. Sorry to actually say what it is. You know, we have a way in this country of giving really ugly things some palatable label. I should have given you an explicit warning on this video before posting this. But this is just the reality, and it's happening all around us. Don't think it's not happening near you, because it's happening everywhere. So until we show some love to the people who have been abused when they were too little and too vulnerable to prevent it, to the people who were raised by addicts and alcoholics and mentally ill people, to the people who were neglected, who were fed a candy bar for dinner when they were 2 years old. You know, for the people who came from foster care, another sort of label and categorization that makes it easier for us to think about and talk about. But it's really, when we say foster care, we're talking about people who have been abused. We're not talking about bad kids. We're talking about kids who have been mistreated in ways that we can't talk about in polite society. Are we going to let them go on and be victims again and again and again? You know, that's where the drug use comes from. It's not recreational. It's not fun. When you're homeless, you take some kind of a speedy thing. I've never done drugs, so I really don't know and understand it. But what I understand from my friends at the DEA, and from kids who have told me who have been homeless, you use speedy kind of drugs to stay awake because it's when you fall asleep that bad things happen to you. Kids who are being trafficked are forced drugs, so they'll comply. May is National Foster Care Month. Every day this is happening, every month this is happening. Can we at least have a conversation and maybe light some fires and maybe do something about this in the month of May? Can we? Please? I hope you'll join me at Successful Survivors Foundation if you're a survivor of childhood trauma, or if you're an ally, somebody who cares. And let's get together and do something about this because we're stronger together.